Hello everyone. My name is Ghada. I'm going to present the adoption of free and open source software using alternative educational framework in colleges of applied science. This was our paper. And the agenda will be the introduction first, and then the statement of the problem, the approach and methodology used to test the suitability of FOSS tools in colleges of applied science, how we implement this method, and at the end, I will show you the result and the recommendation. So as an introduction, as you know, the FOSS or program is actually is an open source program. The user can freely open and change the source code, and they have the freedom to add some functionality, and they have the freedom to modify the source code and to distribute the source code and also the original code. The programmer have the chance to open the source code and modify, like for example, adding a new feature to suit their local needs. An example of these programs is like Linux operating system, OpenOffice, Apache HTTP web server, Java programming, and and many other programs. So what is basically the problem is in CAS colleges, we are teaching some IT courses. We have software development, IT security, networking, and data management. And all these courses, they have a considerable percentage of practical labs and training course and training work. And also, they are carried out by using a commercial tools. Students depend on the institution for the software installation and for the update. And also, the colleges, they have to plan for the budget to purchase this software for the student, and they have also to they don't have the right to open the source code and to modify this source code based on their needs. Beside the IT courses, also there is some tools or software are used for teaching and learning education management and library management, and also for student information management. But all these tools, as I told you before, is basically commercial, and they are resulting in huge challenges like the budget limitation, legal issues in distributing the tools, and modifying the source code. So what was the approaches used in, and for as a research method for and the research method used to test the suitability of free and open source software in IT colleges in CAS colleges and in the IT courses for the CAS colleges? We used this alternative educational framework to test whether these tools are suitable or not. This methodology is actually consists of the following stages. The first one, developing a FOSS plan, and then forming monitoring committee, identifying the stakeholders and identifying the suitable FOSS tools, and also training the candidates' policies and guidelines, and at the end, promoting the awareness and on FOSS tools and FOSS programs. At the end, you have to evaluate the we have to evaluate the outcomes. To do this, we have to we should have the trainer and facilitators, and also we should have the resources like the FOSS tools and also the labs, and we should have the courses like the foundation courses and the specialized courses. So this is the approach, as I told you. It consists of these different stages. So in the first stage, a technical plan has to be done by the researchers, and we have to form the monitoring committee. So the technical plan should include the activities and the responsibilities for each member of the monitoring committee, and also we have to consider the shifting, and the monitoring committee should consider the positive shifting from the FOSS tools to the from the commercial programs that we have to the FOSS tools. And we have a phased approach basically utilized to identify the FOSS tools starting from the foundation, what FOSS tools we need in IT courses, starting from the foundation course up to the specialized course. The monitoring committee ensure the positive movement to these tools or to these FOSS programs. In the strategic area too, it includes basically the policies and the guidelines by the monitoring committee for adopting the FOSS tools. The policies should include the usage of the FOSS, the security issues, and the legal complications need to be addressed. The general guidelines considered and addressed while developing this the FOSS policy. The third stage strategic area should include the training and the awareness of FOSS, preparing a training schedule to train the educator. You have to train the educator to start implement these tools and to teach these tools in their courses, and also you have to conduct some awareness program to increase the awareness of free and open source programs and help the educator and the student to move to this program. The awareness campaign could be conducted through the social media or through the classroom training or through the workshops. In the last strategic area, the FOSS promotion and the identification of stakeholders and the evaluation of the outcome. The monitoring committee and the educator students are responsible for this promotion. For the educator, they can promote the usage of the free and open source software by using them in their classroom and also in their assignment and project. And for the student, they can promote the usage of the FOSS or tools through the using them in their learning activities. And for the monitoring committee, they can promote the FOSS usage by conducting various awareness programs. Also identifying the stakeholder and their technical knowledge and the guideline utilized in identifying the FOSS suitability for CAS. So the result from this research was in the FOSS suitability identification process. Through this identification process, the discussion and the interview with the with the educator, and based on the outcome for the other stakeholder, the suitable FOSS software for all the courses is listed out. And we set some target, like 80% of match was fixed by monitoring the committee. If they reach 80%, we can use them. Otherwise, we cannot use in the courses and in the in the learning processes. So this is just a screenshot from the from a long table. These are the listed courses from the colleges. We have, for example, computer skills A and B, and we are using Microsoft Office. Instead of that, we can use other open source programs like Apache Open Office. For one course like Introduction to Dynamic Web Development, we are using HTML. We can use GlassFish or Apache HTTP server. And in other in another program like Programming Fundamentals, we are using Java. In Java, we can use Eclipse. Web development also, we are using HTML. We can use another FOSS program like Bluefish Editor. As you can see, many programs that we can use, many FOSS programs we can use instead of the commercial programs that we are actually using. You can refer to the full list in the paper. This is just a screenshot from it. Here is just a comparison between the Blackboard. The Blackboard is a learning management system we are using in CAS colleges, and basically it's a commercial program. The college should pay for the lesson, and they have to pay for the companies to get this product. And on the other hand, we have Moodle, which is a free open source program. So we compare these two, and we found that all the features we are using in Blackboard is actually on Moodle. So grading, assignment, assessment, report, survey, and course evaluation, discussion board, mobile support, and so on. All these features are basically available in Moodle. For the educational management activity, we have an e-learning. We can use a model. This is the recommended first tool. In lecture capture, the recommended tool is OpenCast. For online lectures, we can use open meetings. In interactive content creations, we can use that. E-book management, we can use Calibre. And high-stake assessment, we can use Rogo, and so on. These are the different recommended FOSS tools for educational management activity from our research. So in conclusion, there are several possibilities to implement FOSS in the IT programs of CAS. We're analyzed by using the alternative educational framework as a reference model. We set various strategic areas of the reference model, forming a technical plan, monitoring committee, trainers, awareness programs, and policies, guidelines, promotion, stakeholders, and evaluation are highly considered while identifying the suitability of FOSS tools. As a result, we have a list of alternative FOSS tools and software we are identified for the courses of various specialization of IT program. So the recommendation is by adopting the recommended FOSS tools and software, CAS might extremely benefit from the copyright issues and from the low cost of software and the availability of the source code for the learner. The student community also can be could be highly benefited with the rising demand for the latest technology. Also, the adoption of FOSS may also considerably reduce the budget of software purchase, which directly contribute toward a nation's economic growth. It's highly recommended to form a committee for each course specialization to review and to amend the course outcome of the IT program of CAS relevant to the availability of the FOSS tools. So this is the end. If there is any questions? Okay. No questions.